Hey boys and girls, welcome to this week's Temple Kids TV. I hope you've been working on your Names of God flashcards. This week we've got another wonderful name of God, and it's Jehovah Rapha. And Jehovah Rapha means the Lord who heals. And we're in Exodus chapter 15, and we're learning about God and how He brings healing. Boys and girls, sometimes when I think about being healed, I think about maybe just a physical healing. You might break your arm, which would be a bad injury. You might have a bad scrape or a sprain, or we're sick, or we have loved ones that we pray for to get better. But you know, there are different types of healing. Sometimes if you are fighting and arguing with your brothers and sisters all the time and you're tired from that, you need healing. If you have a friend that moves away and that makes you sad, you need healing, emotional healing. And God doesn't just heal our bodies. He can heal our hearts, He can heal our hurt feelings, and He can heal our emotions. And in Exodus chapter 15, we're learning about how Moses helped the Israelites by leading them out of slavery. And what we're learning this week is that this takes place right after a great miracle. So there was this huge Red Sea, this huge body of water. How were they going to cross it? Well, God provided Moses as their leader, and He parted the Red Sea, and Moses led the Israelites across that dry land that God provided when He parted the Red Sea. Well, the Israelites went from too much water to not enough water. When they got to the other side, they ended up in a desert. And boys and girls, we can't make it very long without water. And so what did the Israelites do? Instead of remembering what God had done for them, they began to complain to Moses, "We're thirsty, we're so thirsty, where's some water?" Well, they were in a desert. Well, God led them to a place where there was some water, but it wasn't drinkable. Let's read Exodus 15, and I'm going to start in verse 22. Then Moses led Israel from the Red Sea, and they went into the desert. For 3 days they traveled in the desert without finding water. When they came to Marah, they could not drink its water because it was bitter. So the people grumbled against Moses, saying, "What are we to drink?" Then Moses cried out to the Lord, and the Lord showed him a piece of wood. He threw the wood in the water, and the water became sweet. Now, boys and girls, I put lemons in my water, and that makes my water taste like lemon. But I would think, if I put this in my water, would it taste like tree bark? Well, God was testing the Israelites, and He wanted to see if they would trust Him. He threw it in the water, and the water became sweet. There the Lord made a decree and a law for them, and there He tested them. He said, "If you listen carefully to the voice of the Lord, your God, and do what is right in His eyes, if you pay attention to His commands and keep all His decrees, I will not bring on you any of the diseases I brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you." And that is this week's Jehovah Rapha. He is the Lord who heals us. You know, tossing a limb into polluted water is a very unusual way to make water sweet. But God took what was bitter and He made it better. And so, boys and girls, I want you to remember, it's pretty simple. If you trust God, He will always provide for you and He will always bring the healing that you need at one point or another in His way and in His timing, because He is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals. Let's pray. God, thank You so much for this story from Your Word. Thank You for all of the names that You have. God, thank You that You have a name for every situation that we face in life. And God, thank You when we need healing, whether it's a hurt to our body or to our feelings or to our heart. God, You are the one that will bring healing in Your way and in Your time, and You can take what is bitter and You can make it better. God, thank You for Your great love for us, and it's through Jesus that we pray. Amen. Boys and girls, I'm so glad that you're here. We're going to kind of continue this Rapha theme. Rapha kind of sounds like rap. You're about to hear a great song that's a rap to the Bible. So stand up and get ready to rap along. And then after the song, we've got a special treat for you. So stand up and let's rap.
Oh, yeah. You know what time it is. It's time to learn the book. 1, 2, 3.
These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible.
Yo, it's the Old Testament.
Here we go, here we go.
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, just to name a few. We got Numbers. Joshua, Judges, then a story about a girl named Ruth. First and second Samuel, first and second Kings, first and second Chronicles, we're talking about history.
There were a couple of guys who were up to some good.
We got Ezra, Nehemiah, they helped build a wall around the neighborhood. We got Esther, Job, and Psalms. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father. When we read all the books of the Bible.
And then we got the books of wisdom.
We got Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, the Song of Solomon. He was a wise king.
Then we're moving right along to the majors.
Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel.
Daniel got thrown in the lion's den.
But he wasn't alone.
God was with him.
And then we got the minor prophets.
Hosea, Jonah, and Amos, Obadiah.
Jonah got swallowed by a big fish on his way to Tarshish. And then we got Micah.
We got Titus, Philemon, and Hebrews, James, first and second Peter, then you got John, he was a revelator, he wrote 1, 2, 3, and then you got you. Let's close it down with Revelation! These are the books of the Bible, when we read them it makes us stronger, and we learn about our Heavenly Father, when we read all the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, when we read them it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father when we read all the books of the Bible.
I said these are the books of the Bible. When we read them, it makes us stronger. And we learn about our Heavenly Father when we read all the books of the Bible. Yeah.
Yo, 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 that was the book, y'all.
All right, welcome back, boys and girls. Hope you enjoyed that rap video about the books of the Bible. What a great song to learn. You all, I'm sure, sounded well. We thought it would be really cool to come up with our own rap group. And so I want to introduce our members. We've got on the end down there, we've got Kalo. We've got JK. And we've got Pastor Witty.
Word.
AKA Pastor David. And of course, Coach P, I'm here. We're glad to be here. So this is how our rap starts, okay? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. You gotta soak it in your brain like water in a mop. Jehovah Rapha heals from the bottom to the top.
Oh, hey, good job, Coach P.
That's pretty good.
All right, here comes my part. Moses was a guy who was up to some good, leading people all around his neighborhood.
Woo!
All right, all right,
all right.
There we go.
Hey,
hey,
I think I got one for y'all. Here we go. I think. God has a name, and it's not a game. Jehovah Rapha is real. He's the God who heals.
Woo!
Yeah!
Way to go!
I like that.
All right, it's my
what about
turn.
You, Ms. Kato?
Halo!
Halo! Tell your fam and friends across the nation, God has a name for every situation.
All right!
Yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah. Woo! Word, word, word!
So.
Hey, kiddos, this is P. Witte, the senior pastor here at Temple Baptist Church. And this Sunday, we looked at the name Jehovah Rapha, which kind of sounds like Rappa, which is why you just heard an amazing rap from our team up here on the stage. And as you think about your hint on how you can remember the meaning of that name, I want you to think about that rap, and I want you to think about that name Jehovah Rapha. And if you think about when you get hurt, when you get injured, you play sports, you twist your ankle, you fall, you skin your knee, you slide into second base, you get a strawberry on your knee. What happens is that somebody will come out and they will wrap it. They will put a Band-Aid on your cut. They will take some ACE bandages and they will wrap your leg or your ankle with it just to help with bring out the healing. And that's what the name Jehovah Rapha means. It means the Lord who heals. And when you get hurt or when somebody you know is sick or injured, we have this great name of God that we can talk to him and we can approach him by, and we can ask him to help bring healing into that person's life or even into our life. And all healing, whether it's something that God does kind of instantaneously or something that comes from a doctor or a nurse, it is all a gift from God because he's the creator and he's the one who's given people the ability and the gifts to bring healing into a person's life. And so a great hint to help you remember this name, Jehovah Rapha, sounds like Rapha. And when you get hurt, you wrap the injury, and that's what God does. He wraps us and he heals us. And he makes everything better that we go through in this life. And ultimately, I mean, he's going to bring complete healing to all of us. And as it says at the end of the Bible, in the book of Revelations, that one day up in heaven, there'll be no more pain, no more suffering, no more tears, because he is the ultimate healer in our life. All right? So, man, remember the names, memorize the names. There's going to be a reward at the end of it for you if you can say them all. And we're going to be adding in a bonus name here in a couple of weeks, just to keep you on top of your toes, all right? So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.
Thanks.